My name is Quiz Era, Alex. Don't call me Alex, call me Quiz Era. Not Alex, because I'm no white man. I go by the name Quiz Era in the art fraternity. I'm a painter and an illustrator. I work with variety of media, from digital work to charcoals, to watercolors, to acrylics on canvas. Quite versatile, if you ask. I hail from the hills of southwestern Uganda, that is in Chigezi. Growing up as a little boy, we were so playful about our media. We drew everywhere, on the walls, in our exercise books. We grew up to be inspired in one way or the other by the people around us, by the things we knew, things we watched here and there. For now, as a grown-up artist, in one way or the other, not really grown-up, but my middle years, 10 years and a few more practice, I find myself inclined to themes like philosophy, spirituality, nature, to mention but a few. Painting as an art form is more free, if you ask me. It's different from illustration, which is very audience directed and clear. You are putting yourself in somebody's shoes. Painting is more free. Free to experience, free to express yourself, free to experiment using variety of media, like I had told you before. Watercolors, a bit of acrylics on canvas. For me, painting is very interesting in many ways. And the search and find is where the growth is, if you ask me. As a painter, you don't grow by how many times or what you know, but by how you practice, how many times you experiment in the surfaces that you have, in the media that you have, using the themes that you have learned of. So I find painting much more earth-like, if I may put it in a simple word. Talking about nature, I bring to you an exhibition under the theme consciousness. This exhibition will only touch my work as a painter, leaving aside an illustrator, and this will be my first solo of its kind. In my 10 years or 12 of practice, I have not had a solo, and this is going to be the first. It's going to be an experimentation of all the media that I have learned to use in the due course: the watercolors, the charcoals, a little bit of digital work, a little bit of spray cans, different surfaces, and multimedia, if I mention but a few. So consciousness is a wider theme. This is a theme that is bigger for me, and bigger as a word. So it starts with the very first sub-theme, that is man and nature. I am breaking it down in this sense because I intend to have these as a series of shows, a series of shows under consciousness, but starting with this first one called Man and Nature. Man and Nature, inspired by the ways of our today life, going back to themes like food as medicine, tackling inner peace, talking about duality of existence. You see, young people are now struggling with all sorts of anxiety, mental disorders. And if you ask me, I figured in one way or the other that it goes back to nature. So I bring to you man and nature in hope that we start to open up a dialogue about these things that are encircling us, these things that are affecting us as young people, cross-generating from younger to older, reminding ourselves of who we were. So man and nature is what I bring to you in form of paintings and digital pieces and watercolor pieces and drawings and all sorts of media in the best way I know how. So this is not going to be your ordinary kind of show. It's going to be interesting in a way that I intend to take it away from the white cubes that we know of, that intimidate so many. People have talked to me about art exhibitions. When you tell them, oh, there's an art show, the first thing they ask you, is it free? Do I have to wear a suit? You know? It is for white people only. So I intend to challenge us to take this show into an open space where people can experiment and experience it freely, where everyone is open to come to a dialogue, to build up conversation from here on forward. I thank you so much, Kuonyesha, the Art Fund, for picking me, first of all, among other artists to enable us, you know, in times as these, COVID, where everything is short in supply, the food, artists are mentally unstable, if you ask me, because days like these bring a big challenge to any form of creative, be it innovators or even an ordinary working person, a wananchi, whose basic need is food and water to drink. To us artists, this is what we can call the dark times, where you fall short of inspiration, and there comes Kuonyesha as an art fund that graces us and blesses us with a grant that can help push the art industry ahead. So I tell you, my fellow creatives, if you're out there and you are inspired or you have lost inspiration, there's no other way but to keep the faith, to keep the practice. Whether you are financed or not, whether you have material or not, creativity is all around us. It is gather and search, and once given an opportunity, I believe it is to do the best that you can do out of it. So, see, we have no choice but fall back to the ways of our forefathers, to where we came from, as people, as lovers and preservers of nature in all ways. I bring to you a show that is of philosophy and metaphysics on what fundamentally we are, man and nature, we as human beings, how we interrelate with nature in all aspects, in the deepest of dimensions. Not as a preacher man, don't hold these words against me, but in the most playful way, like the Far East, India and Asia says, uses nature as a playful entity.